Hi, it's Todd from Todd's Workshop here, and I'm back with another Arrows vs Armour 2 film. Back with Toby Capwell, and we're going to be talking about bow weights, everything between 100 pounds and 160 pounds, because those are the kind of areas that people talk about when they're talking about medieval warbows. The problem we have, and this is a really big problem, is that when you're talking about warbows, medieval bows, and the battlefield, is there's no evidence, no really hard evidence. We've got circumstantial evidence, and it's really annoying because we've got armour, we've got drawings, we've got manuscript pictures, we have got arrowheads, we've got descriptions, we've got all sorts of things, but we do not have the artefacts. We do not have a bow, not one. The only ones we have are off the Mary Rose, and that's 130 years later. And it's naval warfare, it's not open battlefield warfare like it was at Agincourt. So we can think that they're reasonably similar, but we can't know. But that has to be the basis. We have to start thinking about things somewhere. But the thing is, there's all sorts of opinions about how heavy bows should be. Should they be 100 pounds, 130 pounds, 160, 180 pounds in draw weight? We can't know the answer to that. We just can't. But this film is really to try and address that a little bit and to explain our thinking behind getting Joe to shoot a 160 pound longbow for the Arrows vs Armour 2 films. And it comes down to one simple thing, and we're in total agreement on this actually, is that if you shot a lighter bow, it's never going to prove the case, do arrows go through armour? You can't do it. So we've pursued the normal in all these cases, all these films, we've pursued the ordinary man's objects as best we can. But in the case of the bow, we're going heavier. We're going a little bit special to answer the question, do arrows penetrate armour?
Take what little bits of evidence we do have and try and get the most out of that. So something like the type 9 arrowheads that survive. You've got the diameter of the socket. What does that tell you about the diameter of the arrow? You infer from that, what kind of arrow weight have you got? You end up at around 80 grams. That's an 80 gram arrow. So what kind of bow is going to throw that well enough? That's where you arrive at something like a 160 pound bow. That's about what's right for an 80 gram arrow-ish. But, you know, that's coming at it from one direction. Then there's the difficulty of, you know, how many people could ever shoot bows that heavy? Is that the most militarily efficient weight? Is there some advantage to making a slightly lighter bow the military standard? Or is it about the standard arrow? Because you got, if you're the King of England in the 14th or 15th centuries, you got to order 500,000 arrows at a go. If you start messing around with different arrow sizes for different archers shooting different bows, it gets logistically very inefficient and complicated. So really, it makes a lot of sense to try and find that military grade arrow. And if you have that, we've decided we do for the sake of the films, then there's another question. How much can you vary the draw weight of the bow and still be effective with your military standard arrow?
The question is, what is that arrow? And that is the real problem. So we have things like the Westminster arrow, one medieval arrow, no bows, one medieval arrow. That's it. But that's a type 16. It's a different kind. It's a bladed barbed arrowhead, possibly what was known as a harassing arrow because it's small and it's light. Mm-hmm. It's not the sort of thing you associate with Agincourt.
And there had to have been standards. You know, when archers show up at a late medieval muster, there's got to be a baseline requirement. You have to be able to shoot at least this bow with these arrows. What is the baseline? You know, is it 160? Maybe not. But how much lighter can you go when you're still shooting within that defined military standard, whatever that is?
Well, I think what we're going to do now is we're going to run a very simple test. We're going to take our standard 82 gram arrow, weighs around about there, that shoots beautifully off Joe's bow, his big 160. And we're going to shoot it from different bow weights, between 100 and 160 pounds, at some 1.2 millimeter thick steel sheet. And we're going to see what it does. Does it shoot left? Does it shoot right? Because the weighting's wrong. Because this is important to match the arrow to the bow. Does it penetrate? Does it not? How deep if it does? So take it away, Joe, on a 110 pound bow.
Yeah.
Beautiful shooting, Joe.
Thank you.
Okay, we're gonna go mark those.
Before we do though, actually, how did you feel about that?
I can tell from shooting the bow that the arrow just definitely does not leave as quick as out of the big one.
So 135, please, Joe. So Joe, 160 pound bow, please. Well done. That's it, Joe. That's all we need. Thank you very much. Right, shall we go and check it out?
Yeah,
let's see what we got. Mm-hmm. Well, here it is. So let's measure up and see what we got. So we'll start with the 110, 11 centimetres. Nine and a half centimetres. 13 centimetres. So 135, 16 centimetres.
Nine.
Yeah, very short nine. And
12.
12. And then we go up to 160, evidently deeper.
18 and a half
centimetres on the 160.
10
centimetres. Interesting, the variation, isn't it? 12. So we've calculated the averages of the depths of these shots. And surprisingly, actually, it's not that different. So there's only about 2 centimetres difference on the average between the lightweight and the heavyweight. I find that interesting, but there are some outliers in here, so I'm wondering, end of the day, we have been shooting you like a maniac all day.
Yeah.
Maybe you are doing a little bit of forward loosen and you're knocking some of the power off. A little bit of unpredictability. I don't know. But Toby, what are your thoughts?
Yeah, I mean, the first thing to say here is that this is not demonstrating that all of these arrows can penetrate armor. They're all going through this plate of steel, so we could understand if people got that impression. But that is not what this shows. This is simply a visual representation of how much energy these arrows are delivering at 15 meters. Now that's interesting, but that is a different thing than saying all of these arrows would pierce armor. That's not necessarily the case. This is a flat piece of 1.2 millimeter mild steel. The question of where the military effectiveness lies is more complicated than that, but this is still interesting. It suggests to me that it is worth pursuing the more in-depth potential of lighter bows throwing the heavier arrows in our investigations.
If there's ever an advert for making another Arrows versus Armour film, what has happened here is it. Look at it against mail, look at it against Gamerson, look at it against plate, the different weight bows.
But then there's also the rain. Is the 100 pound bow gonna be able to do that? Maybe it falls down and is disqualified because it can't make the range. And how does it feel to shoot these arrows out of these bows anyway? Does the archer wanna be doing that?
Well, shooting 85 gram arrows out of a 100 pound bow, they just feel sluggish and they come out clanky. They just don't feel great. Out of the 135 pounder, they're starting to improve, feel a lot better, come out nicer. And out of the 160 pounds, they come out sweet. I've not shot these arrows for distance, but I could tell that you could at least do 200 yards for these arrows easily. And I feel that out of 110, probably wouldn't do 200 yards. Even though in this steel, there's not a huge amount of difference, I feel over distance there would be a big difference.
But it does still suggest that medium weight bow, its potential is worth pursuing in the experiments.
Definitely.
You could imagine that a bow at 135, 140 would be a good war bow with these arrows.
Yeah. I'll definitely say it is. With my own personal experience of shooting heavy bows for you know, 22 mm-hmm. years, that 135, 140 pound bow is definitely a good bow weight mm-hmm. to shift fairly sizable arrows, you know.
So it would be good to know what the distance issues with these three bows actually are.
Yeah.
If for nothing else, to just disqualify the 110 as not being powerful yeah. enough. But that still starts to give you a much better idea of what is the acceptable range for a war bow. Mm. Yeah. And when your archers turn up at the muster, what do you accept and what do you send home?
Yeah,
exactly.
So I think what we've learned here today is actually really quite important. It doesn't alter the fact that we are going to be shooting with a 160-pound bow, because we want to try and answer the question, do arrows go through armour? And you can't do that with a 100-pound bow or a 120-pound bow. You can't answer that question. 160, we can answer the question, really. Not many people are going to be on the field with more than that. But also, what this says to me is you could really validly shoot with 130 pounds and still be extraordinarily dangerous.
It's worth pursuing.
Got to be one for the future. The last question, Joe. So if they made an arrow that suits a 130 pound bow, is that going to shoot well enough off 100 and well enough off a 160? Are you going to hit your targets?
So yes, it will come out of all those bows fine. The fact is on this, I'm trying to hit one single breastplate sized target. If there was a whole row of them, it wouldn't matter what arrow I shot out, or what spine weight arrow I shot out of it, because if I was aiming for that one and it skewed off left, it's fine because I would hit that guy there. It for this test, it is important because I'm just trying to hit a target at 15 meters.
You have to have accuracy.
You have to have accuracy.
But in the case of a battle, you don't have to have accuracy. You have to have probably distance.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so it doesn't really matter. So definitely would say that an arrow made for a 140 pound bow would come off 100 right up to 160. No problem when you're shooting at a body of men.
Brilliant. Well, I think that's really as much as we can get out of this one today. Yeah. It's just opened up an amazing bit of questioning again, because the debate about the weight of war bows and how heavy they were is just going on and on and on. And this has absolutely conclusively not answered that question, which is a shame. But what it does do is it's absolutely conclusively said to me, we need to come back and visit this, because a 160 pound bow, that will answer the question, can arrows defeat armor? But actually it's by no means the end of this story. 130 pounds seems to do the job pretty well, 135. We're going to come back. But Arrows versus Armour 2 is signing off again for this one. But really, thank you for the backers. You have been amazing in allowing us to do this and allowing us to get the knowledge to feed back into the main film. So thank you very much, guys. Loads more Arrows versus Armour films. Go check them out and we'll see you again.